Hello and welcome. Moss Adams is pleased that you joined us for today's session, Fall 2022 Not-for-Profit Accounting and Auditing Update. Before we begin, I'm going to play a brief video.
Welcome and thanks for joining. We're pleased to present our continuing professional education webcast series. Before we begin, please keep the following in mind. You can customize how you view our presentation and interact with the presenter. For better viewing, close all other applications and turn up your speaker volume. You can adjust window size and placement or enter full screen mode using the controls at the top right of the window or dragging the bottom right-hand corner to resize. At the bottom of your screen, you'll see a series of icons that relate to a different aspect of our session. You can download a PDF of today's slides from the slide deck and handouts widget. You can ask questions by typing in the Q&A window and clicking Submit. We'll do our best to answer all questions or follow up via email. If you experience technical difficulty, refresh your browser by hitting the F5 key. Today's session offers one CPE credit. To receive credit, you must meet the National Association of State Boards of Accountancy requirements. You must attend at least 50 minutes of the session and respond to at least 75% of polling questions. To participate in the polls, please check the button next to your answer within the slide window and click Submit. We'll track your progress and alert you when you've earned CPE credit. You can then click the certificate icon in the CPE Progress widget and download your CPE certificate. Don't worry if you can't download your CPE certificate today. We'll email you a copy in 2 weeks. If attending this webcast in a group, you must complete our group CPE attendance sheet, available in our slide deck and handouts widget, to receive credit. Please have all group members sign it and send only one sheet per group. CPE credit can only be awarded to participants registered as themselves and isn't available for participants who view the on-demand version. This presentation is not legal, investment, or accounting advice. We encourage you to seek the counsel of a professional service provider to apply this content to your specific circumstances.
Before we kick off today's presentation, we're going to start with our first poll question. Where is everybody physically located? A, West Coast. B, Midwest. C, Northeast. D, South. Or E, International. I'll give you a few moments to respond. To respond, please click the button next to the answer that you choose and hit Submit. If you cannot see the Submit button, please enlarge the slide area. So we'll leave this open for a few more moments. It looks like a large majority of you are from the West Coast, so welcome and welcome to the rest of you. We really appreciate you joining our webcast. And now I'd like to introduce today's presenters from Moss Adams. Ali Chalak, partner, and Johana, Flores, senior manager. Their bios and contact information are located in the webcast console if you would like more information. And now I'd like to pass the floor over to Ali to get the presentation started.
Thank you, Danielle. I'm Ali Chalak here. Thanks for being with us today. Really excited to go over the recently accounting standards with you all. We'll be talking about the CECL ASU standard. Then we'll jump into the non-financial asset contributions or in-kind contributions standard. Then we'll finish it off with leases. Then we have a few slides on the cryptocurrency space. And then back of this presentation, there are some accounting industry updates for you to also refer to and reference to. With that said, once again, we're going to talk about the accounting standards and how it applies to the not-for-profit and higher sector. So let's just jump right into it.
Danielle, if I could turn it over to you for the polling question.
Absolutely. Here we are at poll number two. How familiar are you with CECL? A, what is CECL? B, I know a little, feel behind the curve. C, I have a solid foundation. Or D, I've audited a CECL model before. As a reminder, if you would like to receive CPE credit for today's webcast, you will need to respond to at least three of the four polling questions. I'll give everybody a few more moments to respond to this poll. And the results.
Yeah, and the results, you know, my opinion are surprising.